I think the thing that stands out for me is how much fun you can have in such a short period of time. We laughed, we giggled, we worked our asses off, we created great music, and the time just went so fast. But we just enjoyed ourselves working in the studio every day. It was a challenge. You know, we had to come up with new things every day. Maybe that's what it was. It was so fresh and new, and every time we rolled tape, it was like, wow, that's different. We haven't done that before. And Jimmy wants a new sound. All right, well, let's go dig under a rock and find a new sound for Jimmy to help him with his vision. Without Mitch and without Noel, Jimmy, I don't think would have been as great. Mitch's playing is superb. He is one of the very few drummers I've ever heard who could actually keep up with Jimmy from an imaginative point of view. In other words, if Jimmy would nod to him, and he would know by Jimmy's little eyebrow movement exactly where to put a beat or to change something, or maybe just to let fly and put some incredible fills in, which would keep the music buoyant and bubbling. And Noel was amazingly inventive. When you listen to how good his bass playing is, it's in the pocket, and it's melodic as well as it being rhythmic, which is the perfect foil for what Jimmy was playing, which was rhythmic and melodic. And the three of them were like this. There was a great meshing of three talents. Chaz was the father figure. Chaz was the man who had done it already. He was the bass player in the Animals, and he had the experience in the studio, had gone on the road, he'd really done it all. And he was a tough guy, and he knew what he wanted, and he had respect for the musicians, and he had tremendous experience, and they relied on Chaz as their mentor. There was a lot of editing. There was a lot of time spent looking at the past, looking at those tapes that he created of that previous year. You're referring to the year of 69. There was so much separating of the wheat from the chaff that we had to do. Many, many performances that were not up to par had to either be re-recorded, or the ones that were at least up to par had mistakes on that, had to be fixed up. So we spent weeks listening, IDing each tape. And then Jimmy would know. The amazing thing is that he would come into the studio and say, pull tape, that tape, play this part, spin this part over here, and he would know exactly where he was on that tape. So, okay, I need to fix this. Bang, go and put a new guitar part on. There's a song on this box set called It's Too Bad. It's a very personal story that Jimmy is telling about his relationship with his brother. His brother had been in jail, come out of jail, went to see Jimmy, and I was bugging him and asking him for money. And Jimmy was really pissed off and got really angry about it and wrote the song and performed it in one night. It was Larry Young on organ and Buddy Miles on drums and Jimmy and no bass. And it's such a heartfelt, gut-wrenching performance right off the floor of the studio. And the tone of the guitar is just like, it's magic. The last track on the album is a track called Slow Blues, and I just happen to have the tape running, and it's a little demo, and you can hear me sort of desperately trying to click knobs and stuff and getting the sound together, and it's a lovely heartfelt performance that stops about quarter way through, very much like Jimmy's life ended.